In my last video, I talked about cleaning and the power of soap and water as a cleaner. While cleaning mechanically removes visible dust, dirt, debris, and most germs, sanitizing takes an extra step and eliminates even more germs. So in this video, we'll talk about sanitizing our homes and what that means. So, what is the difference between cleaning and sanitizing? Cleaning involves using soap and water with some friction to physically remove dirt, grime, and most germs from surfaces. So, cleaning removes most germs, but not all. This is when sanitizing enters the picture. Sanitizing after cleaning takes the extra step and safely kills more germs. Sanitizing reduces the number of germs on hard surfaces to a safer level, with at least a 99.9% reduction in germs. It's excellent at eliminating bacteria that causes foodborne illnesses like Salmonella, E. coli, and Campylobacter. This makes sanitizing great to use in certain areas of our homes. Can you guess where? So, where should we sanitize? Well, there's certain areas in our homes where cleaning is just not enough. And it's important that we safely remove as many germs as possible to prevent foodborne illnesses. So, the best place to sanitize in our homes is the kitchen. We should sanitize surfaces that come in contact with food, like dishes, kitchen counters, tables, sinks, toys that children put in their mouths, and pacifiers. Because contaminated surfaces can cause contaminated food, resulting in foodborne illnesses. This is why the primary concern of sanitizing is food safety. So, how do sanitizers work? Bacteria such as Campylobacter, Salmonella, and E. coli can cause food poisoning, upset stomach, and diarrhea. When sanitizers come in contact with bacteria, it damages the outer layer of the bacteria by disturbing the lipid structure and denaturing its proteins, causing structural damage and leakage, resulting in the death of the bacteria. To sanitize, you can either use heat or chemicals. When using chemicals like store-bought sanitizers, make sure to read the label because it'll tell you what surfaces to sanitize and how to use the product. Sanitizers will list the active ingredients that kill the germs, like citric acid, lactic acid, dimol, hydrogen peroxide, and many more. Because the primary concern of sanitizing is food safety, the chemical is used at low concentrations, so it will not leave behind dangerous residues that can harm us. Whichever sanitizer you choose, make sure you research its toxicity to ensure that you don't harm yourself or your family. For sanitizing to be effective, you should clean the surface first. Remember, all you need to clean is soap and water. Use a little elbow grease to scrub and rinse. Then we sanitize by spraying or wiping the sanitizing product on the surface or immersing the object in the sanitizing liquid. Allow it to remain on the surface for the recommended dwell time. That's the amount of time the sanitizing product needs to remain wet on the surface to kill the germs. As I said earlier, you can also sanitize using heat. When using heat, the surface needs to be exposed to high heat for a designated amount of time. One way to sanitize after cleaning an object is to immerse it in hot water that is at least 171 degrees for 30 seconds or more. This method is great when manually washing dishes. If you have a dishwasher, don't worry. It will do the sanitizing job. Some surfaces can be sanitized using high temperature dry steam to eliminate germs. Just follow the manufacturer's instructions on how to sanitize using steam. Now that we've learned how to sanitize, we can safely cook a great meal for our families without those pesky germs. To learn more about disinfecting, click on the links in the description box. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos like this one. And don't forget, cleaning is a family affair. Now, let's get it clean.